हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मैक्नोटेक यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटेड 350 क्वेश्चंस फॉर थियरी ऑफ मशीन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ 351। अ गवर्नर इज सेड टू बी स्टेबल इफ, सो व्हेन वी कैन से द गवर्नर इज स्टेबल। सो इफ द रेडियस ऑफ रोटेशन ऑफ द बॉल इंक्रीज एज द इक्विलिब्रियम स्पीड इज इंक्रीज। मीन्स हियर सपोज से this is the radius of rotation, okay, r, and when the speed is increased, here sleeve lift upward and radius of rotation increase with the speed is increased. So here we can say the radius of rotation of the ball increase as the equilibrium speed is increased. Now when the radius of rotation of the ball, answer is decrease as the equilibrium speed increase, the governor is said to be unstable. Here the main thing is unstable. When we can say it is unstable, so radius of rotation decrease with the equilibrium speed increase, then governor is said to be unstable. Next is, a governor is said to be isochronous when the range of the speed is zero, means n1 minus n2. Okay, so initial speed and final speed, if it is zero with all the radius of rotation of the ball within the working range, negligible the friction, then it is called the isochronous. Okay, so answer is yes. Now the Porter governor cannot be isochronous. Yes, because in Porter governor we cannot say that n1 minus n2 is equal to 0, because initial speed and final speed is always there. When the speed increase, then the with the rpm increase, radius of rotation is increased. Okay, so next is, in the Hartnell governor, if the spring of greater stiffness is used, then governor will be, so yahan pe if the stiffness is greater, then it is less sensitive. Okay, when we can say the governor is sensitive, if the sleeve moves up and down very fast, then it is called the sensitiveness of governor. But if the stiffness is greater, then it is become a less sensitive. Okay, now when the speed of the engine fluctuate continuously above and below the main speed, the governor is said to be hunting. When the engine fluctuate continuously above and below the main speed, okay, so if the sensitiveness is high, then there is a hunting. Okay, a very sensitive governor will cause the hunting. Okay, it is right. Then for isochronous Hartnell governor, what is the equation for that? So equation is A, mg plus s1 upon mg plus s2 is equal to r1 upon r2. Okay, where r1 and r2 is the maximum and minimum radius of rotation of the ball, and s1 and s2, that is the maximum and minimum force exerted on the sleeve respectively. Okay, now next is, effort of governor is, what is effort in governor chapter, what is effort? So effort is, we can say, mean force exerted at the sleeve for a given percentage change of speed. Okay, so effort is, it is a particular force exerted on the sleeve for the given percentage change of the speed. Okay, now what is power of governor? So power of governor is effort into sleeve lift. Okay, effort into sleeve lift. But here amongst these three answer, there is no right answer. So here D is the answer of 360. Okay, so what is power again? It is the effort into sleeve lift. Okay, now the effort of Porter governor is equal to, so what is the answer for this? So answer is D, 4c square upon, just a second please. Okay, 4c square upon 1 plus 2c small m plus capital M into gh. Okay, small m, that is the mass of ball, and capital M, that is the weight of the sleeve. Okay, now next is, for the isochronous Porter governor, the controlling force curve is a straight line passing through origin. So yahan pe, if there is an isochronous governor, then the straight line is passing through origin. So it is correct. Now in a controlling force diagram for the spring controlled governor, just a second please. Okay, the controlling force diagram for a spring controlled governor is a curve passing through the origin. So answer is wrong. Okay, because for the spring controlled governor, so here you can see the spring controlled governor, it is a stable, it is not passing through the origin. Okay, so basically here T theta diagram is given here, not T theta but controlling force versus the radius of rotation diagram given here. So you can see here and understand it. Okay, so this is a isochronous governor, which is from the center, then stable governor, okay, and unstable governor. Okay, so here basically the controlling force diagram of the spring control governor is a curve passing through the origin. Okay, now 365, the spring control governor is said to be unstable when the controlling force decreases as the radius of rotation increases. Okay, so as I said, unstable means the controlling force Fc is decreased as the radius of rotation increase. So it must be controlling force increase with the radius of rotation increase for stable governor. Okay, so here answer is C. Now in a spring control governor, when the controlling force, answer is C, increase as the radius of rotation increase, is said to be stable governor. So it is the same question, but you know, from here, from there, so it is almost the same questions. 367, a spring control governor is said to be isochronous when the controlling force, answer is D, remain constant for all the radius of rotation. Okay, so for spring control governor it is isochronous for when the controlling force remain constant for all the radius of rotation. Now in a spring control governor is found unstable, it can make stable by, how we can make the stable of spring control governor if it is unstable? So answer is decreasing the spring stiffness. Okay, so by decreasing the stiffness of the spring we can make it stable. Okay, so 368, answer is B. Now 369, a spring control governor is said to be stable if all if the controlling force line when produced intersect the y axis. So answer is B, below the origin. So yahan pe stable, it is below the origin. Okay, so you can see here, for stable governor, stable governor, it is below the origin. Okay, for unstable it is above the origin, and isochronous, that is passed from the origin point. Okay, so 369, it is below the origin. If the controlling force line of the spring control governor when produced intersect the y axis at the origin is governor said to be, agar origin se pass ho raha hai, then governor is said to be isochronous. So answer is C. Now next is, if the controlling force line for the spring control governor when produce intersect the y axis above the origin, then governor is said to be unstable. Okay, so once you see this figure, you can give the answer of all these questions. Okay, so above the origin, unstable, from the origin, isochronous, below the origin, stable, and same question and answer here, but it's, you know, The relation between the controlling force and radius of rotation R for the stable spring control governor. So again here for the stable FC is equal to AR minus B. So here answer is B. 372 answer is B. Next is a spring control governor is said to be unstable if the relation between the controlling force and the radius of rotation FC is equal to AR. So answer is wrong because AR that is for the isochronous governor and AR plus B that is for the unstable. Okay, so here disagree and AR plus B that is the unstable. So answer is B. Okay, so 374 answer is B. Then the Hartnell governor has its controlling force FC is given by FC is equal to AR plus B. When the R is radius of rotation and AB is constant, then governor is said to be isochronous. When it means the isochronous governor is FC into AR. Okay, so this is the equation for isochronous governor. So for particular in this equation, if A is positive and B is 0, then it become FC is equal to AR, which is isochronous. So here the governor become isochronous when the A is positive and B is equal to 0 in this equation. Okay, so from so friends, today this 25 question is enough. Next time we will start from 376. So friends, if you like this, then like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.